goal of treatment is to control the disease. As we said before, dermatomyositis is an autoimmune disease, which means that the immune system has an abnormal response against the normal tissues. So the goal of treatment is to bring down the immune system a little bit so that it stops attacking the tissues and it gives them time to recuperate. Prednisone is a very good medication in the sense that it suppresses many parts of the immune system and acts very fast, so it can be very effective. However, it does have many side effects and especially increases the risk of cardiovascular disease, increases cholesterol, can make diabetes worse or can cause diabetes in patients who have a tendency for high blood sugars. It can cause high blood pressure, mood changes, osteoporosis. And these are like few of the side effects of prednisone. That's why we don't keep it for a long time. And that's why we're investigating alternative treatments. These are all the immunosuppressive agents that we have, that they do exactly the same thing. They suppress the immune system, but specific parts of it and with less side effects. However, these tend to take a long time to start working, usually like 2 to 3 months. That's why we need the prednisone as a bridge therapy until the other medication kicks in. The most common biologic agent that we are using in dermatomyositis is rituximab, which is an antibody that is manufactured artificially, and it's against B cells. B cells are part of the immune system that make the antibodies. So the idea behind it is that if we kill those cells that make the antibodies, we will not have the autoantibodies anymore, and maybe that will stop the process of the disease. We now see that exercise, not only it is safe for dermatomyositis, but it has multiple benefits. In the past, we were afraid that if the patient exercises, it can accelerate the destruction of the muscle, but now we know that is not true. Exercise has been shown to reduce inflammation and increase muscle strength in patients with dermatomyositis. So it's kind of a natural anti-inflammatory medication, although having said that, that is not enough for treatment of disease. That's why we need the medications. Exercise can help increase endurance. We definitely recommend going to physical therapy. Besides exercise and giving them a tailored exercise program, they can help us in diagnosis of the disease and monitor disease progression. Sometimes when the patient is very strong, we are not able to detect any weakness, but the patient might lack endurance. So that is where the physical therapy comes in. They can detect earlier an upcoming flare of the disease, because the patient first will lose endurance and then the muscle strength. As we said, dermatomyositis can affect the muscle, the skin, and the lungs. And that's why it's a disease that needs multidisciplinary approach. That means both rheumatologists, neurologists, dermatologists, and pulmonologists can be helpful, and each one brings their own expertise. So if the patient has some lung involvement, the patient needs to be followed by a lung doctor to monitor disease progression. If they have severe skin disease, the dermatologist can also help us in treating the local symptoms. Another recommendation where the dermatologist can help us is do an annual skin check. These patients, they take immunosuppressive treatments, which by themselves can slightly increase the risk of skin cancer. And that's where the dermatologist can do a skin check every year and prevent progression of any underlying pre-malignancy.